for the next battle.
Okay. All right, how's it going, everyone? Top 8, Tekken 7. Here we go. We have Krokop versus Kolonov. I wonder if I can bring those scores down the bottom. I don't want to mess up this stream. This ain't my stream setup. I think we'll just leave it at the top for now. I'll see if I can bring him down later. Anyway, I am here joined by Dr. Jin. How you doing, mate?
Yeah, pretty good, man. It's been a pretty good tournament so far, and I think it's kind of getting actually a lot better.
Me too. Yeah, it's been great. This is Josky, by the way. Yeah, no, it's been good. It's good to see we've got a few interstaters as well as Sydney boys up in the top 8. This is one example right here with Krokop being a local lad versus Kolonov coming down from Brizzy.
And both players actually have been playing very well today. I played a couple of like matches and stuff. I still, for this particular one, I actually feel though, with the kind of buffs that Brian has gotten and Lars and Jewel being a little bit nerfed, you know. Not to say like, you know, the meme is actually true now, we should buff Lars, but,
but
essentially, yeah, they're going pretty even though. I think they need to establish like their spacing a bit, kind of figure each other out, because they haven't actually played from the pools, so we'll see how they go.
That's exactly right. Krokop, of course, was the winner of the last two ISBs, making it back out of loser's bracket, but this time he's doing winners, so let's see if he can hold on to it. But Colin has been playing extremely well. I've given him a couple of sets, and he's done really well. I'm very glad he's back part of the Tekken scene again, because he's doing great. Turn mics down a bit. I have no idea how to do that, mate. maybe this? Voice? Turn that one down a bit. Have you got on here? How's that? Is it still sealed out?
Sorry guys.
How about
mine? Is that
now?
Better?
Testing 1, 2, 3, how's that? Is it sealed out?
Okay, cool.
Alright. Krokop drops the first game. This is first of two, so it's best out of three until we are up to the grand finals and winners final, I think. But for now, it's best out of three. Call another game up. Let me just adjust that score. Fight. And hit save. Slightly on him. How's that?
Is that better, guys?
I think we adjusted them both. Yeah, we have to adjust them on an individual headset. So hopefully it's good. Round two. Fight.
I think we're good.
Yeah, I think we're good for now. Yeah,
yeah. Chat will let us know if we're not.
So back to the match. Kolonov did very well. Unfortunately, like we said, this is best out of three, so I'm not too sure if we have enough time for Krokop to actually adjust, because there's already one game, like one round down. Good decision.
Brandman top 8? I don't think so. Let me read out who is top 8. Everyone in top 8 is Krokop, Kolonov, Dion, CTC, Arquez, Handsome Boy, Lazy Dave, and Cruise Control. So no Brandman, unfortunately. Kolonov up two games here against Krokop. Is he going to send Krokop back to the losers and make him crawl his way back up? Alright, I think the mics should be good for now. Let's just roll with it, guys. I apologize if it's too loud. Like, it's not my stream setup, so I don't really know what I'm doing, but let's just do it.
Yeah. Okay, so Peter showing signs of life.
He's on his way back up. That's good. He's never got one round. However, Kolonov still on game point here.
Yeah, Krokop definitely like a very strong, long set player. And we'll see, even if he does get knocked out of this one, I'm pretty sure he'll take the time to readjust in case he needs to play a game, the same character.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Kolonov strong up, and Kolonov takes it with a perfect.
Loud statement.
So Krokop sent into losers, and he's the current reigning champion of Tekken 7 at YSB, so great stuff to Colin.
Can I please
Dion versus CTC.
It's been a while. Stop, I missed you.
So the announcement then was, I don't know if it came through on the mic, but CTC's got Eddie back. He's a capo player. He's part of the Dark Side. This is the first time we've had the Eddie build here at YSB. And he just makes top eight. His boy's back.
We're quite excited now, you know, but if you think way back, I actually started starting to taste a bit of salt that he used to instill in me.
Oh, 100%.
So it's good to see him back, but I'm pretty sure we'll be like regretting that very soon.
I've got to say, a big part of the fun though is just giving him shit about being an Eddie player just because you can. Mm. In saying that, I've heard the guys say that Eddie is very fair at the moment. He's a very fair character.
And of course his opponent, Dion, as we all know, in the last Evo, got top 16, right?
Not top 16, I think it was a pretty good, top 32 or something like that.
He got knocked out by Kokoma and it was someone else, but he did extremely well.
Oh, it was actually JT.
Knocked
him out.
Yeah. So, you know, so even though we have a very strong player, rocking the Jack, his main, unfortunately he's going against a character that hasn't been in the game that long. So all the changes, I'm not too sure if he's very familiar with it. But if anyone knew this matchup, studied for it, it'll definitely be Dion because he does his homework all the time.
So I'm going to find out, guys, if I can move the scores to the bottom. I know it's a bit distracting there at the top, so let me find out for you.
You said, there's one question we have. We need to move the scores to the bottom.
Alright, so here we go. Eddie versus Jack. Both boys playing their mains.
Traditionally, Jack does quite well, actually, against Eddie. When he's in relax, he can do that down back one. They'll usually float him if he does that at the right time. But otherwise, it'll just basically stop him in his tracks.
Very good.
Punish.
CTC, a massive reputation for being a great capo player, having even made, not even made, rather, won a tournament in Japan at Sugamo Arcade, which is the biggest arcade for Tekken. Locked up to one of their weeklies and won it. It was incredible. That was back in tag too, obviously. Now he's back. KO. Round two. All right. So the guy who owns his stream setup isn't here right now, so I'm gonna try and work this out and hopefully I don't break anything.
So now I'm getting started with a strong start. He's basically just bullying CTC right now. Basically hitting him, catching before for the ones as Jack does. His combos, I'm not too sure if CTC has an answer right now. He's just basically on the defense and unfortunately he's not really getting his offense off, which is what he's basically known for. Round three. Fight.
Oh god. What am I doing?
Set the rocket.
I think we're just gonna have to deal with it. It's not really covering the life bar, so let's just rock it. Back to the match. I don't want to get too distracted. So Dion's up 2 rounds. And CTC coming back 1 round.
KO. Have I? Round 4.
Fight. Okay.
But I actually want to say this is the first time Eddie's back in the game, and if he wins this tournament, I'm pretty sure half the basically everyone's going to scream nerf, but we'll see.
Exactly. Let's see how he goes. Of course, Dion obviously doesn't have much experience playing against Eddie as well, since this is the first time we've had it here at YSB.
If I was CTC, you know, I would do that. Just rock the new moves non-stop until he figures it out and force him to learn the matchup.
Exactly. And even a tournament setup, like, you don't necessarily have long enough to adapt that quickly.
Yeah.
And there he goes. Two rounds.
See, there you go. There's another tool that Jack has to float.
Oh, great carry there by CTC.
New combos.
Guys, I apologize about the mic. It's out of my control. It's just what was here, so we're going to have to deal with it. No punish down is out for it, too.
Oh, debuggers all day. No break on the throw.
Oh, it's pretty big damage.
Ooh. Can he close it out?
Just one jab away. That's all he did. Oh, he went for the wake up, but unfortunately got jabbed out. So Zeon up one game here.
Yeah, unfortunately basically the rage move's not so good if you have so little amount of life that where you can't actually survive absorbing a hit, right? So,
yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Round one. Fight. Okay. So this is gonna run back on the same stage, and let's just see if CTC can make any adjustments.
Well, he's off to a strong start, and he picked it up well. He was two rounds down, and he managed to bring it back up. So maybe he's got a bit of momentum.
And it looks like he does, definitely from this round.
Absolutely.
Let's see if he can close it out.
Very nice. Very nice.
Safe pokes. Round two. Fight. Very nice. Very good move back too. Unfortunately, still in the game, but very good move.
Oh, whiffs that.
Nice start. This combo.
Wow, CTC's really got momentum going right now. This is what he's known for as well, just pushing the buttons and then, you know, forcing the opponent to play his game.
Yeah, exactly. He basically goes with his offense and forces.
Oh, there he is. He's two rounds up as well. He's back. Bit more back down on these players. Zeon is originally from Melbourne, still classifies himself as a Melbourne player, but he has resided in Sydney for a number of years now. He's played overseas. People have seen him up on whose stream was it? Was it Shooties or Kurokuro? Yeah, he was on Kurokuro's stream quite a lot last year when he was in Japan playing. So he's got a bit of international experience, but of course that doesn't mean much now against Eddie, who's just been put into the game. No punish again. It is a bit hard to punish in the moment, especially when you're so focused on what to do next.
Cross frames.
Oh, it actually hits because he doesn't know what it is!
Doesn't do the touch.
Oh, and he takes it as well! CTC is now up a game as well. It's 1-1. Both players here just need one more game to make it through.
Both players looking very calm.
Again,
just concentrating.
This is actually winner's bracket as well, so whoever does lose this is still going to be in... Fight.
Yeah, obviously, unfortunately, like right now, because Eddie is still quite new, like we haven't like explored him enough to get his optimal combos. So,
100%,
obviously,
yeah.
I would do the same in a tournament. I would just use what I know works, basically.
That's
right?
Exactly right. Yeah. Just keep it safe. This might not be optimal. This, as much as people are saying this is the final build, it is not the final version of the game. So take everything with a grain of salt right now. Mm. Is that Lord Silver in the chat?
Oh, I would actually like to see CCC just actually press more to get out of the wall. Like, you know, he could have like sidestepped just to, you know, basically not have his back to the wall. But
it is,
yeah.
It,
but under these high pressure situations, you know, you don't want to be flinching because Jack's got that 4-4-1.
Exactly.
Catch anyone moving.
And Dion's putting the pressure back on right now. He's playing much more aggressive than he was last game.
There you go, another flow.
Doesn't follow up though.
No break.
Great combo.
Can he close it out? Okay, so
what's that time? See, he still gets a bit of a follow-up though. He doesn't have rage, so his damage isn't going to be too big.
And
gets hit by the rage drive in reverse. Dion is one round away from knocking CTC into losers.
Losers bracket.
Dion's actually adapted quite quickly.
I must admit, he's floating CTC really well. He's also, you know, known to basically when he's turned, he's putting on the pressure, and that's where like plus frames, it's making him guess, it's taking him to the wall.
But unfortunately, he does take that round there, and CTC is out. Unfortunate for him, I should say. Dion is happy at the moment. He got past the early player. He's happy. Oh, a couple of familiar faces here. A few local boys. We've got Handsome Boy 123 versus Your Boy Alchemist. I'm not going to spell his name with all the weird sort of leet speak. I'm just going to type.
Yeah, this
Alchemist.
Is an MIRC. Let's just spell it properly, eh?
Yeah. Alchemist versus the Handsomest of Boys. Let's get a bit of play cam going there. There it is.
This is a very interesting match because both of these players are very, you know, they've got very good fundamentals, you know. They sidestep. Both of the games, these characters, you know, it's a lot of like, you know, jab, sidesteps, downward ones, and you know, not too much craziness, but I guess it just comes down to who's going to be more solid, you know.
And that's exactly right. So I realize it says Guilty Gear at the top. Where is they don't even have Tekken in this list. I think this is like an anime dude thing. Oh, plus? There we go. Okay. Game. Tekken 7, guys. This is all you need to be playing right now. Boom. Save. Boom. Tekken 7. Mm. Let's go, baby.
So we have, you know, I've had some more
bit of a way to the stream. From the lads.
Yeah. No stranger to the top 8, right?
Absolutely. But for both these guys, in particular for Handsome Boy 123, I believe the last YSB Alchemist unfortunately didn't make the cut, but he is a very, very strong player. Mm. He's someone we do expect to perform well, and he's brought it back today. However, this is the loser bracket now. Whoever loses, he's out.
He's out.
So one of the local boys is going to get done. I thought Alk was a baldy. Why would you think that? He has fantastic hair.
Head full of hair.
Yeah. Oh, mate, he's going all the way through. He's going all the way through. I'd say he's got one of the best sort of heads of hair in the city.
Yeah, nicely, top tier hair.
Oh, definitely up there, definitely up there.
He's got some pomade in there, looking pretty slick.
Yeah, always.
Let's just see if that translates though. If that's going to help.
Let's see
you.
If he can play Kazumi as slick as his hair.
Because Krokop, he didn't have his hair gelled in, unfortunately. The last time when he did win.
Exactly. That's a very good point.
I say, look fresh, play fresh.
Look fresh, play fresh.
So we've got a new map. Looks pretty good. I like it.
Okay, I'm gonna stop messing. The chat can't see. I'm trying to mess around and move those scores down. It's triggering my OCD, but it's not happening.
So who we go? Everyone's just establishing.
Yeah, I think in these first couple of games here, it's going to be just trying to get in each other's face. Both these guys, again, I know we say this for a lot of players, but both these guys tend to adapt over time. You know, for example, when I sit down with them and play casuals, you know, I don't have a rough time for the first 5 matches. After that, I just get wrecked.
But with that said as well, these guys have also played each other forever. So if you're, like, they know each other's habits, you know?
Yeah,
if you start
true.
Seeing, like, you know, like, you think it might be random ducking, or you think it might be, like, you know, certain things that they're doing that's not, like, solid fundamental, it's because they've played each other. They know their habits. And that's why they're doing some of these things here they traditionally wouldn't do against someone you just started playing.
That's exactly right. That is very true as well.
But as you can see, like, you know, Feng just, like, establishing, like, a lot of lows, chipping away, getting your health down, and then that's when he starts throwing the mids, you know?
Yeah.
So very evasive move, so Kazumi might not necessarily just be able to throw buttons out after, even if it is, like, safe.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Combo?
Oh, he does manage to pick him up, luckily.
Oh! Red... That was a drop that I didn't usually see.
Luckily, breaks a throw on the wall, and just a little bit of lore, I guess, but Handsome Boy 123 actually has a bit of trouble playing on 2P, but not for that game. He's now up 1. When I was playing him earlier, he was playing on 2P, and he was dropping a lot of his combos, so...
I actually heard Alchemist actually saying that this particular stage here actually gave him a bit of troubles, you know?
Right.
As I was looking at it, he was playing, like, Raven, Master Raven at the time, but he did say he wasn't a fan of it.
Right.
And not only that, but... I think four breaks might actually serve him in this one. Might actually make a difference.
Yeah. On the topic of these characters, yeah, Kazumi has been buffed. I don't know exactly what the buffs are or the entire list, but her low has been buffed. And she has a move as well that now puts you, like, flips you over on the ground. I don't know what the input is, unfortunately, but...
But it's a very solid character, you know?
She is, and I think she needed the buffs. I think in the last version, since her down forward 1-1 got nerfed, she was a little bit boring. A little bit too straightforward, if you know what I mean. I think now she's a bit fairer.
Yeah, of course, yeah. And Fang always a powerhouse in this game. Kind of suffered in tag 2 because of, like, the tag juggle combo, but in this one, back 1 into shoulder, that was, I'm going to say, way too much damage.
Exactly. Aren't they not allowed to discuss character changes? Who said that? Why would we not be able to?
Well, you know, we're not going to give you very specific, like, things that might change, but... minor changes that we all kind of know. I'm not going to give you specific frames, anything like that.
Yeah, exactly. And even if we did, like, it wouldn't matter. This is not the final version of the game. Like, things are going to change. You should know that this is a beta build.
Yeah. So Alchemist actually doing a lot better now.
Still very even. But actually, yeah, it looks like he's putting a bit of pressure. A bit of a miss input there as well. He's not happy about that one.
There you go. Round four. Wow, he's actually doing pretty good in anticipating the lows now. I think he's trying to get a bit of the rhythm. But there you go, there's that.
That's just bringing back to us all it takes, mate.
You know it's a good move when the whole camera basically freeze frames, right?
Yeah. Magic claw there, but no follow-up possible. And just gets a little bit of a kick to the womb. Final round. Fight.
Wow, that was great. Very nice sidestep. And of course his bow knocks to the floor.
Yep, so he's gonna get the juggle off that as well.
The break takes him back into the center of the stage, which is where he wants to be. Here we are. Oh, he's
looking very good
now. This is when Feng does his work. When he's got the life advantage,
100%.
He's chipping you away.
Oh, but big rage damage there as well.
Oh, he bet it all.
He put it all in. He went for a Hail Mary, but no bueno that time. Great start from Handsome Boy 123, making it through.
I don't blame him. You know what? He bet the bank, but from the middle of the screen there, he probably would have been able to kill. Not only that, but Handsome Boy was basically throwing a lot of buttons out, so you know it didn't work this time, but I like that he tried.
He gave it a go. Gotta respect that. Just gonna check that I've input his name correctly. He does cruise underscore control, that's interesting. Alright. Lazy Dave on 1P, Cruise Control on 2P. Lazy Dave is another Kazumi player for you guys watching there, so keep an eye out for any more changes that have happened to her. And no, we are not under an embargo, and we don't know any specifics anyway.
Cruise Control, I'm actually quite impressed. I haven't seen him before. Apparently, he's like an online player, but I was really impressed watching him play a couple of casuals. You know, obviously, he's taken time to not just win online and use his online tactics, but he has surprisingly good fundamentals. He's doing the right combos, and he's like, I feel like he's adjusted very well, and like, you're basically going to see that.
Exactly.
But has he played enough? Has he ever like been on the, like, you know, the stage here and playing?
Well, that's the thing. He's made top 8 a few times now since he's been coming to YSB. However, he has never done too well once he has made it to the big stage. So far. So he's really good at getting out of pools, but actually progressing through top 8 is something he hasn't been able to grasp just yet. Unfortunately, chat, I know it's a bit of a joke, but we're not going to tell them what stages to pick, and we're not going to shut up during music because this is a top 8 of a tournament. There's plenty of casuals that were recorded all day, so if you go back and watch the archives on twitch.tv/BlankaEXX, as well as just search him up on YouTube, there's plenty of archives there for you to go back through.
We have a lot of footage of the new maps. We also have a lot, like, we do have a lot of indie play as well, so if you're here to, like, check that out, yeah, definitely watch this top 8, and then you can obviously load that up and, you know, view it for yourself.
Exactly. Songs off of Lazy Day, being a little bit patient with his back to the wall, of course. Round two. Fight. Cruise Control's Jin is very good. It's definitely his strongest character. He does play a few characters. Honestly, though, I really, the only one I struggle against is his Jin, and I struggle a lot against his Jin. He plays his characters very well. And he's also a pad player.
We forgot to mention that as well. You know, there's a lot of debate, you know, about the pad versus whatever, but I think, like, yeah, whatever you're most comfortable with is always going to be the best. What you learn on, you know?
Exactly. And I mean, his movement is really good.
Yeah,
like,
exactly.
I never
spacing very well. Yeah.
Yeah, I never thought you could move like that in the past.
And not only that, you know, your pad's always going to sit comfortably in your hands, not like on your lap, on the table. So you never have to worry about that too much, you know?
That's true. Yeah. Playing with stick now, I mean, because we're used to playing in the arcade, playing with stick, It does always ruin me, like, depending how high the chair is, you know, what angle my knees are at when I'm sat on there.
It's weird.
I know it sounds silly to some people listening, but, like, traditionally we're not console players, we play in the arcade.
Yeah,
so it was always the same vibe, you know? Lazy Day off to a strong start, by the way. I really like the patience he's showing.
Oh, he should have went with a mid there.
Yeah. I remember Lazy Dev actually telling me that he's trying to focus on his spacing a little bit more, and he gets a lucky hop kick there and finishes it off in style with the rage drive. I wouldn't say in style, because I think it was more of a bit of safety. If you followed up with anything else, it could have whiffed, it could have not finished.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
The bracket's are on smash.gg, yeah. Hit up smash.gg, search YSB, and you'll be able to find them. And there's a link from Necromancy Black. Thank you, my man. Alright, sorry, let me just adjust the score there for you guys. Lazy Dave, up one game. So let's see if Dave can make it through and represent the Kazumi demographic. Since we lost the Alchemist.
I'm not too sure, like I'm watching them both playing. They're both playing really solid. I can't really see any errors in Cruise Control's game or anything like that, but I think he's just getting outplayed. He is.
Lazy Dave, like you said, he's no stranger to the big stage. He knows how to stay a little bit more, what's the word, like, not
composed.
Stressed.
Yeah,
composed.
Yeah, he's more composed.
Exactly. And it really shows in the gameplay. Look at that.
Yeah.
Round two. Fight.
Nice magic four.
Yeah, that was cool combo. Magic four.
And we're getting downstairs. No,
oh, unfortunately, he has whiffed it. Cruise Control maybe needs to work on his Spanish game a bit better. Because he is an online player, he has really only got a lot of experience on Tekken Tag Tournament 2, so there is a lot going up punish at the moment, which is maybe something he can improve on for next time.
Yeah, I think sometimes you think like online players, like you have more players, right? So you can play against more characters,
exactly.
For example. But the problem is, like, you know, there's so many different styles and all that, whereas, you know, when you play with like a community, you can really like learn from it. You can talk to each other, basically,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly, you can just turn around and say, what was that on block? How do I punish it? Which way do I sidestep? Yeah. Something you can't really do when you're playing online.
Yeah, and the big unfortunate thing is this. Unfortunately, he's an online player, and Kazumi, you can't play online.
Yeah,
which is a big
exactly.
factor. Yeah.
Exactly.
But regardless, he's doing pretty
yeah,
well in this set.
Yeah, he's now. But he drops it again. He needs to stop dropping these combos. It's costing him a lot.
But luckily, Cruise Control hasn't been like punishing him like too heavily for those drops.
Yeah, not yet, but that was some solid gameplay. Cruise Control actually got the advantage at the moment, one round away from equalizing the score.
See, in this situation, I feel like because, you know, they're at the wall, they should be sidestepping out, you know? Because if you sidestep down now, we'll basically put Kazumi's back to the wall.
No punish on a down forward two, that's massively punishable. There's another example of just a bit of lack of experience against Kazumi.
Yeah, let's be real, you don't have frames, but that shit looks slow as hell.
Yeah.
I'll just run up and fucking do it unblockable.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, God.
But Cruise Control takes it nevertheless, staying very composed there. Despite having been down a game, now he's equalized and it's 1-1. Run.
So they're going to stage select?
Oh, they've got no wall stage. No wall stage. So this is just going to be a face.
Wait a minute, can you actually select stage? Was it random select?
Yes, loser select.
Oh,
yeah,
okay,
no worries.
Okay.
So loser can either change character or change stage. That's sort of the rules we go by in general.
Okay.
Yeah.
I see what he's doing. And it's got a white kimono on and a white map.
A little bit of camo going on.
Yeah. And unfortunately, Cruise Control wasn't able to know the map he was going to select, so he couldn't select the right color for his uniform. Because Jin does have a white white costume as well.
Thanks guys for sharing the brackets in the chat.
Wow.
Oh, also somebody blocked it. Laser Day very close here. And he takes it with a down forward one.
Yeah. No need to risk any big moves.
100%. Yeah. Especially with a down forward one like hers. Like, even though it was there, it's still good pressure. This is one of the new stages. I can't remember the name. Is it like Azure or something?
Infinite Azure, yeah. It kind of reminds me of, Interstellar. With that planet they go on with, there's like a really big wave that's coming.
Oh, yeah.
I'm pretty sure it's not that, but yeah. But to me, it's that. So it's that. Wow, okay. Hasn't used that all game. Finally pulls it out. Counter here.
Pops
it
with yellow.
It's going to finish this now here.
Well, that is actually very, very close. And this is loser's bracket as well, so whoever loses here goes home.
Both of them just chipping out the legs, in and out.
Yeah, it does look like they're walking on water, but there's actually some sort of, it's a very shallow lake.
I'm pretty sure he tried to do the tank kiss, but maybe it didn't come out.
Well, I did see
a down four, yeah.
I saw a shake of the head from cruise control as well, so he knows he can. It's just lack of experience means you don't just... Yeah. Your muscle memory needs to go. Great low block there by Lazy Dave. He should close this out. He'll do the rage drive. Sorry, rage arts. And there it is. One round away from taking this game.
Yeah, very, very high risk move there, because if he hit it, it might not have been able to kill him, right? But yeah, he risked it, but I respect that, you know? He still has a game to play after that, wasn't the final round, so why not?
Yeah. Yiggs, I hope you're not still watching this, mate. For those who didn't see, Yiggs was here about less than an hour ago. His fight was at 6, wasn't it? I don't know, but he left a while ago. No, his fight's at 8. Oh, I looked away for a second. Lazy Dave's taking it, and that's it.
Taking it, yeah.
Roll up to Lazy Dave, but clutching it through there.
I hope Cruise Control, you know, watches this match in the future, realizes that because, Lazy Dave basically threw tigers like crazy and, got away with them, you know? Whether they hit or whether they weren't punished properly, but that could have like easily changed the outcome, I believe. It would at least be another game.
I'm actually going to spell Handsome Boy without an I this time. He mixes it up himself, so no issues, but I'm going to put a Y in there.
Yeah, and today we do have like a couple of people from like Brisbane and Melbourne here as well. Unfortunately, no Melbourne in the top 8.
Does Dion count?
Well, he's been here for a while. It's kind of
it's up for debate. Yeah. It's up for debate, I reckon. But it comes down to what he says he isn't. He says he's Melbourne, so I'd say he's Melbourne. But otherwise, right now we've got still remaining. We've got Kolonov.
He's the winners.
Yeah. We've got CDC, Handsome Boy, 1-2-3, Crocop, and Lazy Dave remaining. We did have a few other people up from Melbourne. We had Brown Man, and we had the Beasts. Now you can wave. Now you can wave. There you go.
I think CTC's powered down. He's put his man purse away.
Oh, you guys want to see Zahn in the background? There he is. There, just chilling, just waving chilling. To the camera.
Just chilling. Oh, we just lost some screamers after we put Zahn on. We just lost half the screen once we showed Zahn. Sorry guys, not back in, we'll never show that again.
Alright, Handsome Boy 1-2-3 versus CTC. Handsome Boy 1-2-3 on his 1P, which he likes. Look at that shoulder hitting, relax, yeah. That is delicious.
What an answer, what an answer. Oh my god. Oh. How many shoulders?
Held down.
That's what I like about Handsome Boy's play, you know? He keeps it playful. He's a very serious player, but at the same time, he keeps it playful.
He does. He's always healing. He's always smiling. I love it. He makes the game fun.
And it's cool, because, you know, sometimes it might actually trigger some of his opponents as well.
It definitely does. Oh, no, seriously, putting a bit more damage back on his own shoulder. Oh!
Oh, no float. Doesn't matter.
He's just going to chip out his head.
Oh,
and the shoulder again.
Oh, my God.
A little bit of flip of the fingers over the CTC there.
CTC, give him the one finger salute.
Points him up there. Pretty close to the wall.
Oh, just letting him know, don't duck. Please don't duck on me.
Gets out of relaxed quick smart that time. Oh, yeah, he's always at any time. Back to the mix-ups. Oh. But he breaks the club, that's great.
Yeah, close him up as he was going into relax.
Oh, no punch on the shoulder.
Oh! Here we go.
Wow.
Literally the most sexy great chart ever go.
Oh, I believe anyway.
Oh.
Very nice, very nice. Quite pleased he picked the white Cheeto jacket as well. That looks very nice.
Makes him faster.
I think it does.
The Cheeto.
Hands boy putting the pressure back in there, mixing it up, pushing all the buttons, confusing him. See, this is girlfriend, fiance has just rocked up to watch him lose this one.
Watch his man.
One game to Handsome Boy, 1, 2, 3. This is still loser's bracket, by the way. Whoever loses this is out.
Round one. Fight.
He's too scared to stay in the last now. I love it.
That shoulder is such a good option. I'm wondering if he's like actually just hitting him out or he's actually pressing buttons as he comes out of relax.
I don't know yet as well. So like to those who are watching, don't yet just be assume that it does hit it, because again, this isn't the final version of the game. These guys are playing a tournament. I don't know if he's pushing a button or anything.
Oh my!
That time he certainly was.
Just cut it if he ends it with it. If he ends it with it.
Oh!
Oh
my
God!
Let's take that round.
Round three. Fight.
What a smack talk going around for both the main TO as well as a player.
Bit of banter going back and forth. Friendly competition.
That's how we do it here. It's interesting, we do take our rivalries quite seriously, but we know how to have fun with it.
Yeah.
CDC drops a combo there. Oh, he takes it anyway! He's now 2 rounds up! Is he going to equalize the score?
That's Handsome Boy's antics, actually. Going to cost him now.
Possibly. Maybe he needs to just calm his farm a little bit.
Oh, showing he's not phased.
Oh! Not today, son. A little bit of an ankle tap. He says it is today.
Oh, what a nice low parry
as well.
Oh, such a pretty new move to spin.
It is, isn't it?
Oh, there you go.
On the last inning, three. Up the shoulder that time, but it is very, very hard to punish in the moment a lot of the time. He tried something else.
Oh my god!
He's loving that. And Handsome Boy 1, 2, 3 knocks out CTC. Your boy Eddie.
I don't know
how to feel much, man.
But I feel disgusted right now with how many of these he landed.
I feel a little bit dirty. It's like, I can't really give this analogy on stream. It's a bit rude. But you know, there's sometimes you do something and then, I'll just pop it there, mate.
Yeah.
You know, when you're doing it in the moment, it feels like it's the right thing. But once you finish, you're just like, what have I done?
Hmm.
you know what I mean? I don't want to get too detailed.
But you know what? At the end of the day, it's worked a couple of times. And the alternative is you could have chipped him out with a low. So you know it hasn't been like launch punisher. He got like one of the launch punishes. I'll just do it just for like, you know, just to basically mess with his head.
Yes, exactly. Old school rivalry, right now. Right here, right now.
Oh.
We have Crocop, champion of the last two YSBs versus Lazy Dave. These guys go way back.
These guys, you know, they've been playing for like a very long time, obviously. With your traveler as well.
Iron Fist Tournament 7, Ryan Fury, Kazumi Mishima.
So here's the thing, right? So, for a while, the Crocop, like, you know, obviously, like, they're after this, we're going to go have dinner. Then Crocop has, like, a couple of pies that that he's holding on for Lazy Dave.
A couple of pies he bought down at Port Stevens.
Yeah.
So, you know, if Dave wants his pies, he might want to throw
these. Yeah, might want to at least hold forward just at least half the game.
Round one.
But either way, these two are going to have like a... I already know this is going to be a really hard match.
What do you guys like heading that other track? I haven't even really been able to hear the music yet at the new stages. It's been so loud here today.
There's a wall slap.
We don't know what the VR thing is yet. There's a comment there about VR mode. We don't know what that means yet. It's not in this beta.
One taunt.
Oh! Once he gets a wall. Oh! Cheeky, cheeky.
Round two. Fight.
Lazy Dave also with the Beyonce cheering him on from behind. Yes, open those. Just open them.
Obviously an input error there.
I'm taking the mic off for a sec. I need to eat
chew some
peanuts.
Can he close it out? I'm horrible at guessing these things. Every time I say it's gonna kill, it never kills. Okay, well.
It does. If he wants his fries, you better rethink this.
Okay, Crocop coming back, showing some signs.
Fight.
This music is horrible. I hope that changes. I really hope
that. Yeah, I don't know what kind of like commentator powers that I have, but if I had any, I would definitely make them change the stage.
Mate, like, that's horrible. I swear to God, whoever chose this was just like smacked out on acid. Like, that's what it is. Who's not bringing it up?
Nah, let's not ask him to change the music. Might take another year off its release date.
Yeah, I want the game to be delayed for a music track.
Yeah.
Just complain about it once it comes out so they can patch it in. Good equalization around him, the last hit whips and then Lazy Dave capitalizing on it.
This is where Brian does his magic at the wall.
Oh, and there it is!
To the corner.
Breaks the first wall, we'll take it in a second.
Oh!
Lazy Dave takes the first game there. Obviously not too concerned about those meat pies. Wait for Crocop's freezer. In Crocop's freezer.
Round one.
Good composure there from Lazy Dave though. These are two guys who are playing against each other again and again and again over the past 10 years. More.
So hit out of the orbital hill there. Didn't get a full juggle from it.
Yeah, I think this stage looks really, really good. I think the design is good, but this music is pretty, yeah.
Doesn't capitalize on the wall splat too much. It's the second wall splat, so... Nice good punish.
Quirk up is extra kick. Really good. Oh, you fight the same with the leak.
Oh my god, they're just...
Quirk up too good in the clutch situations. Tom and Earth may be irking Lazy Dave just a little bit there.
Was I anticipating a high? Was punished for him? Nice get up.
Oh! Get back on the wall, boy.
Oh, wow.
Wakes up on Lazy Dave. Very convincing win on that round. Mike dead. Mike dead. Wait, you can't hear me. Well, I hope you can hear me. Say something?
Yeah, hello?
Yeah, I think it's fine.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Oh!
There it is again.
Oh, unfortunately it's right in the corner of the wall, so it doesn't get like a, like, the full combo.
Great anticipation there as well.
With punish. I'm not too sure if that was intentional, but it yeah.
I think it was. I think he had a read on him coming at him there and went for it. Thanks, Jordan.
Oh, nice with punish. This could still be Krokov's game.
It
he's,
is.
He's amazing at
the clutch.
Clutch
situations, but oh, he stopped the clutch. Great job, King.
There we see the nerves. Okay. Is he going to do his breakout move?
Oh, Lazy Dave takes it. He knocks out the former YSB champion. The last two YSBs, Krokov has won, but not today. Where his long-time rival, Lazy Dave, has taken him out with
Krokov. There's a My Pies now. My Pies.
Deliciously buffed Kazumi. Who's the flipping for 1P? That's how you know we're arcade players. Man, I wish these scores were on the bottom though. I don't know why I can't edit, like I use OBS, I can edit on my, I don't know.
Wow, so they're fighting four positions here. They're flipping a coin to get the P1 or P2?
Who's got it? Oh, and Lazy Day takes 1P. Give the chat away, boys. Give the chat away. Say hello. Alright, let's get scores only. Mate, I really want to put these scores on the bottom. It's really triggering me. No, okay. Alright, I'm getting over it. Sorry.
Get these away from me.
Do you want to commentate for a bit?
Nope.
Josephine, trying to bail from commentary. Sick of me already.
Yeah, sorry guys. I'm actually just sitting back and like watching the match, you know what I mean? Because obviously like I know all these people, so like I'm very invested in like the outcomes and I'm trying to like, yeah.
Yeah.
Not only that, but we have this like barbecue cracker nut sitting right in front of me, opened up.
Yeah, I'm gonna go find a pop. I want to be hungry for dinner. We're gonna have dinner after this. It's gonna be good. Get ready for the next battle. Get some nuts in here, mate.
Round one. Fight.
Lazy Dave versus Handsome Boy, 1, 2, 3. Both boys hungry to get through here. This is, again, this is still losers, so whoever loses this is out. It'd be nice if the stages have story significance. I think that'd be cool.
Yeah, we won't be able to find that obviously until the game comes out. There'll be like possibly like a story mode or whatnot, right?
Yeah.
So, you know. I definitely see maybe something happens with the transitions and stuff. That looked pretty cool.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
Wow. Strong start by Lazy Dave.
Round two. Fight.
harnessing the power from his last win.
100%. he needs to keep up that momentum as well.
Exactly.
Get straight into it, you know?
Oh my...
Okay.
And I think he's going to purposely try to close it out with the shoulder. If he does...
His face is actually a bit serious by now. I think he's a little bit worried, which is interesting. Oh, he went all the way through.
Chipping away. Wow. Thing doing is the wall. We can't backdash out of it. Basic have to guess all of this. Oh, okay. Safe.
There it is. Keeps it simple. Keeps
such
it clean.
A good move. Back
of course,
such
he does a little
move.
Little BM sort of
shoulder at the end.
Shoulder.
Daniel.
CDC getting a call from his mum. So I'm gonna give his phone back. It was just charging over here.
Wow. I just look at how disrespectful is. He'd be using the same four moves back to back. He's just headbutting him high low.
He knows he's in his head. He's frozen up a little bit. He needs to snap out of that and get back to where he was against Krokop. And so he didn't need to change it up because he knew he was frozen. Lord Silver, you cannot beat him. Or can you?
Lord Silver, can you stop screaming advice through the chat? Like, you know the players can't read this, right? Just letting you know.
Sidestep? Yeah, Hensible 123 is actually sidestepping a lot right now. Gets the back one counter, hitting the shoulder. That's delicious.
Oh, is there no launch punish though?
Yeah, unfortunately not on that one. It was on a bit of a weird angle as well. Hensible, he goes with a cheeky low to close out the round. I'll get Zahn back on the cam for you guys after this round. Excuse me, got a play there. CDC coming back to pick up some more of the cracker nuts we got on the desk. And the phone goes back
on track. So,
good punish.
Nice.
Spring kick.
Spring kick gives a juggle because you're faint, basically.
Yeah, just that's pretty much it.
Yeah,
Oh, we got the low as well. That was actually a pretty good use of rage drive there as well because it took the pressure that he had with his back to the wall. And obviously, as you can see, he
followed
up on it.
You're running in, you know, expecting like to do something, and he just throws it out from like a fairly like long range distance. So if you run in or you stop, basically, I liked it.
Exactly. Yeah, it was good.
Oh wow, misses his combo. Oh wow, what a great
touch there. Just standing there. Good back to us, but again, off axis. No good. Oh, great magic four there. He should close it. Yeah, he closes this round out. Great little clutch moment by Lays today. Even Handsome Boy 123 himself giving that a bit of a clap. Smiles from the boys if you want to see real quick.
Round four. Fight.
No conversion on the low trip.
Wow, you know, a lot of, like, I used to think that move, that, you know, the one where Kazumi flies at you. First time I saw it, I basically thought, you know, this kind of looks a bit slow, it's a bit useless. But obviously, you know, as a, knowing the options from it, actually makes people freeze up.
Oh, 100%.
You know?
100%. Oh, wait, they possibly bringing it back here as well. Fight. Quick play is one round away from winning this game, but if Handsome Boy wins this, Dave gets knocked out. If Dave wins this, he equalizes the match point. Goes for the low slide.
Oh, out of range. Well, Dion in
just
the back
screaming
here,
in the background.
Sitting in winners, yelling move sounds. I don't know what he's doing.
Surrounded by women, yelling at a game.
He thinks he's actually like giving move advice, but he's just basically distracting everyone here.
great hot kick by Lazy Dave there as well. He's going to bring...
He's a running mix-up.
Very low. Oh! when he takes the laser, he equalizes the rounds there. It's now 1-1. It is now 1-1. Pressure's on both here. Whoever loses this actually gets knocked out. They can't see you, mate. It's we're trying to wave through the camera. That's the wrong scene.
Oh. I take him to the wall.
I feel we're going to see some new stuff from Handsome Boy 123. As in what we haven't seen from him yet today.
He hasn't really used a lot of his like back to mix up, and I think he's going to bust it out now.
He is, and he's going to start throwing a lot as well. That's what he tends to do when he gets behind a little bit. He'll incorporate the throws into his game much better.
Oh, wow. Checking the legs.
Round two. Fight.
Oh, doesn't he confirm the 1-1-2?
Look at that tiger beyond the down, mate.
Oh,
tiger, tiger's the one.
Oh, well.
He'll bring him to the wall there.
Oh,
finish it. Oh, he does.
Great adjustment. Great adjustment.
Round three.
One round to one round.
Oh, he's in with the 4-4. Combo. Because you can zoom in, we'll always get to the wall. Oh, tiger for your troubles.
Oh, no!
Oh,
no!
Oh, no!
Oh, oh, wait!
Nice, finally.
Brings him up with the wall standing three.
Oh, here you go. What did I say? He's the actor mix-up, right? Another one? Oh, no!
Shot
up
to the wall. Oh, no! Oh, no! Those punishes was 1-1-2. Better than that.
Oh! He goes for a parry.
Wait, try to take some pressure off. I didn't know who was going with that! Wait, today, 1 round away from knocking Handsome Boy 1-2-3 out of YSB. Quick little and I quote shut up from Handsome Boy to the crowd. Oh, way launch.
Gonna get for the running mix up now? What's he gonna do?
He goes for the slide.
Trying to space him out.
Tio distracting everyone. This is it.
If he doesn't drop it.
And he takes the laser day. Knocks out Handsome Boy 1-2-3. He's now knocked out. Two of our best players here. Krokop and Handsome Boy 1-2-3. Laser Dave is on fire. He's on fire. Bit of cam action. Zion in the background for you boys as well. On his phone looking at the chat. Get up and get
Tio versus Lazy Dave gets embraced by his fiancée, giving him an extra power up for the next round.
By the way guys, this is winner's finals, so it's a best out of 5 now, which means first to 3 for the unacquainted. We have Dion versus Kolonov. Do we want to add Dion as Vic? No, you know what, I'm not putting Vic next to his name because he's not in Sydney. I like this mouse. Kazumi is quite good. It's quite interesting as well watching Lazy Dave's Kazumi. It's very different from Alchemist Kazumi. There's obviously a lot of similarities, but they both have their own unique playstyle, which is really cool for a character that's relatively straightforward. It's good to see two different, very diverse playstyles. Hold on, I'm setting up a 2P by the looks of it. We've got Zep or Zahn just chilling in the background.
Yeah, Colin's been playing very well today. You know, he kind of like took a break from like the last like iterations of the game. I mean, he's always been playing, but he's never really like taken the like serious as his main game.
Exactly.
Yeah, and he's told us like, you know, like he very likes this version of the game. He came down earlier a couple of weeks back before and he played it at Bamco. He really enjoyed it. Got like a really good session in. And his verdict on it, he loves the game, you know, and as we all do. But, you know, does love for the game really, can he beat this monster that we don't hear that Dion?
Both of them have OHN sticks. Show the camera. That one there, that one there. Both boys are previous OHN champions. So Dion for Tekken and Colin for King of Fighters. Colin, of course, as Dr. Jin was just saying, now back into the Tekken scene, and absolutely loving Tekken 7. So hopefully we can bring more boys over, convert more boys. Yeah. It's saying that Kolarov does have a bit of a history with Tekken as well. It's just that he departed the scene for a while, wasn't a fan of tag too.
And now he's back, you know. We can tell he's got all the fundamentals, so it won't take long for him to pick it back up. Right?
Exactly.
You know, any veteran like player here, like, you know, just has to learn the changes, you know, to the characters, and
exactly.
They're pretty much up there. But you know, like all the people at home and all that, I'm pretty sure once you get a copy of the game, you'll be going into practice mode, you know, finding out what you need to do and learning it, like all the characters.
As for what stick that is, I'm actually not sure what brand it is. What brand is the stick? Is it Mad Catz or Razor?
It's a Razor stick.
But they haven't broken, so they must be pretty good.
Yeah.
Yep, OHN, the big yearly city tournament. We like to call it the Nationals because that's what it is. For Tekken at least, but I mean, Bam, stepping up, it's going to be huge down there as well, so.
This is going to be very good for them because he used to main Lars as well, and he did play him at the start. Of Tekken 7, but his complaint was that, you know, obviously he got nerfed a bit, and you know, we all know Dion only likes to play the cheapest of characters.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. Well, recently, oh wow, Cole taking the first round.
Watch.
In saying that, I think there was a bit of a change of heart from Dion when he went to Korea and spoke to Saint. Was it Saint or was it Kurokuro? Anyway, one of the guys in Korea or Japan pretty much shot him to stick to Jack, don't use anyone else.
If a Korean tells you to use that character,
You don't question it.
Oh, nice punish.
Oh,
does he have tackle moves? That's still good damage.
Uses the razor to close it out.
Colin wins this, I want him to pop off, I want him to jump in front of the camera and just go, I don't even play this game.
100% do it, because to my knowledge anyway, Colin hasn't traveled to Japan to play as long as we have. Maybe he's dabbled in a bit, but not as long as we have. He hasn't gone to Korea, he's played a little bit in the arcade in Brisbane, I guess, but this is certainly live, Majestic Zed.
And not only that, but Dion, he went to, was it Japan or Korea? And fired a machine. And
both.
Played like 10 or 15 hours straight.
Yeah, mostly in Japan, but he did do it in Korea as well, where he was playing with Nii, Saints, a few of the guys. Dion, he's up two rounds here though.
Oh, no punish there, but I really like the pokes that Khan's throwing out, and this hit pretty much every down back form he's thrown out, yeah. Any condition, like, Dion to, like, actually try to start ducking.
Oh, I think that's going to get blocked, and it certainly is. Final
round. Fight.
Round's equalized. This is really close.
Yeah. And these games are going really fast as well. It's going really back and forth. Yeah.
It's either or. If one guy gets his pressure going, that's it.
These combos, okay.
Kolarov's fundamentals are just incredible. You know, for someone who did depart the scene for a while and has only come back with Tekken 7, he's so good! And he takes a cheeky little down four there! Kolarov one game up, however this is a best of five, so first to three. Let's see if Dio can adapt and bring it back his way.
And Colin's like high level in, like, you know, all the games he plays. So he has the right approach to learning and understanding games. Such a good, like, fundamental.
I was going to say earlier, like, there's definitely things he brings over from other fighting games. You can absolutely see it.
You know, we know for sure. He's holding a championship stick.
Yeah, exactly.
So that goes a long way. Okay, the last place you want to be, up against the wall.
with Jack in front of you.
Round two. Fight.
I actually like the last costume in this.
It's quite nice.
That cape's pretty sexy. I hope his wind poses, he just like does the cape flick.
Really looking forward to who gets to the losers final and then into the grand final.
Liam fighting his way back out, doesn't get the low, breaks the throw. Wow, okay. Doing a bit of like tech and tag combos here, doesn't bounce. takes it out.
You know, I was gonna say as much of Tekken 7 as I've played, I sometimes do still find myself just doing a bit of a Tekken Tag 2 combo, you know, because it was a combo in Tekken 6 as well.
Yeah.
So for the past 10 years, it's what I've been doing. So it does come out sometimes. Beyond convincingly ahead, this game though.
Did he commit? No.
Unfortunately,
hits him with a flawless move. Connor's just going to shred back into it.
Thanks again, Necromancing Black, for linking the brackets. Who are you? I feel like I know who you are. Who is it? Oh.
Very low parry. Misses a juggle though. Wow, he's been hitting with that hand sweep plenty of times. I would just keep doing it that quickly.
Oh no, I don't know if that was an accident or... If it was maybe anticipated, like, Dion was going to trap...
They was going to react, yeah.
Exactly.
And you'd have moved before that was safe, so he figured, okay, well, Dion knows, you know, it was safe, so I can go in and do my work. But unfortunately, yeah, didn't work out.
Gotcha. Mod on the Discord. I've got to get on that Discord server. Feeling lonely at home these days. Yeah, actually, Fade just told me that you won that on Thursday. He just came up to me and told me that. So congrats for that, man. Who is Chibi Churro? Who are you guys? You know us, but we don't know you.
Fight. Wow, accident on the jump, no punish on the 4-4-1+2.
I hope you guys who are just in the chat can make it to Bambo. There's a bunch of us coming down. I'd love to meet some people I haven't met in the community before.
Yeah, that's the right excuse. You should just go out to Bam.
Bam in Melbourne.
Oh, round of hit, you move.
Come on, freeze it up a little bit, trying to get in there, get a couple more hits in. Oh, there it is as well! Good clutching by Kolarov. Of course, he was at danger there, being hit by the late drive as well.
So Kolarov's coming back. Basically, you know, if you're gonna, you know, do one more with me, I'm not gonna make it easy. I'm not gonna let you have, like, you know, three rounds straight.
You gotta fight for it.
Oh, here comes a dirty mix-up.
What are you
going to do? There's a big kiss there. Punish.
Bunch of us go.
Oh man, he's in his head. Don't flinch. You're going to get counter-hitted. You're going to get a robot punched to the face.
Don't call too early though. It is only 1-1 and it is first of three, a best out of five set. But it does look like Dion has built his momentum. Maybe he learned something in that first game he lost and he's giving it back to Kolarov now.
You know, you do certain moves, you know, just to see how they react to it, you know?
Sorry, is it 2-1 now? My bad. 2-1 to Dion? I'm too busy talking to the chat! Yeah. Oh, yeah. Alright, cool.
Nice launch punish on the slide. I should take it out there. Round two. Yeah, he has whiff updated that. Sorry about that, guys.
Sorry about that, my bad. Yeah. My bad.
We're just trying to look after, you know, the people in the chat.
Yeah, exactly, man. Just trying to get people out there. That's what we do. Yeah. And people talking about Evo Japan get me all excited because I don't think we're going to, well, not a lot of us will make Evo US this year, but Evo Japan January next year. I know there's a lot of Aussie boys going over, so it's going to be hectic.
Nice down 4-2. And can he take this out?
Oh, it does. Kolarov might have to change something up here. I know that Dion is now obviously putting a lot more pressure back on, so...
Yeah.
It's hard to say if you should be patient or just should be more aggressive back, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I think the thing is, like, you know, with a character like Jack, it's not about... You just need time to condition someone, you know? You gotta go in there and do, like, down back ones, like, 4 or 5 times. Then after that, the longer the game goes,
yeah,
you know, it's harder to read them out of...
Oh, 100%!
Yeah, because now they know, they're willing to do both options. Yeah.
Dion takes it, knocking Kolarov down to loser back, and Kolarov's not done yet. He's not done yet. Dion though, showing his strength and experience in that matchup there.
Yeah, not phased. got his little posse of like girls at the back end.
Yeah, always surrounded by women. Yet, like, the thing he loves most in this room is absolutely this game.
Yeah. Yeah. After he's satisfied his first love for Tekken, he's come back to his posse of girls. His second cherished love.
Looks like he's educating them on his ways now as well.
Yeah.
And they're interested. That's great. What a player, man. All right, so we've got Colin versus Lazy Dave. Lazy Dave holding a fourth down for Sydney. Can he do something
Lazy
special
Dave
now?
Obviously coming off like two great performances.
Yeah, let's even keep it up.
Yeah, and the Colin obviously, you know, he's probably still thinking right now what happened well in his last match.
Best out of five, first three again. Colin versus Lazy Dave. So I didn't put the cam on so you guys could see Zahn. I'll get him off for a bit. There he is.
Dude, he's at the back, looking unimpressed as always.
He's watching Street Fighter. That's disturbing. Alright, let's get into it. So we've actually got Lazy Dave on P1 there. Let me just swap that around. Alright, let's see if Colin can come back strong after that loss to Dion. But,
yeah, he's still playing this end. He's probably still thinking about the last match.
Yeah, he has had time to rest.
He's just thinking like, yo, if I do beat this guy, what am I going to do on my next match when I play Dion again? But he needs to focus on this match now. Because obviously, David's on the tear. You can't just, you know, you need to respect the opponent in front of you, basically.
Exactly. Yeah. And Dave showing that he needs to do just that as well with that. It is very hard in tournaments, but at the same time we say that, but let's not forget, like, Kolonov is holding an OHN championship stick.
Yeah.
He's won tournaments by
the
player.
He's got a strategy. I'm pretty sure he's got, you know, he's ways to, like, you know, bring his mind back into the game.
Exactly, just mentally reset, you know, like, this is a new game, it's fresh, let's, you know, what didn't work against Dion might work now, let's do it, you know?
Exactly, yeah. And he's warmed up, he's been playing, you know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely. That running mix up at nothing. Yeah, it does get the low as well, but does block the get up kick.
Lucky it wasn't close enough for the wall splat, and there you go.
But didn't break the 1+2 grab there, unfortunately.
Point blank, just throw it out.
Dave.
Yeah. That's a good way to incorporate, like, grabs into your, you know, like, game. Just point blank, bam, when they're least expected.
Yeah, 100%.
When something's safe and they know they're expecting to block something, you just throw a grab out when they're least expected.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Oh, actually, speaking of which, Lazy Dave also used to main Lars back in Tekken Tag Tournament 2.
Is there a single person who didn't play Lars?
Are they the only one?
Yeah, you might be the only one. But everyone else who basically wanted to do good at it basically used Lars as like a combo filler.
Yeah, exactly. But Dave, like, great parry there as well to close out this round. For Dave, it was more of a main though. It wasn't just a filler.
Yeah.
So he's someone who understands the character very intrinsically well.
Yeah, exactly.
And he did play him a bit in Tekken 7 as well.
Yeah, exactly.
It
yeah. Like, unfortunately, he's abandoned, but you know, Lars is quite like kind of like a linear character, but his moves are good.
Yes.
That's why people play him, you know.
He's
got
exactly.
good wall carry, he's got good damage. But
tracking.
You know, this is a different game though, you know, it might not fit him in this game, but he's
exactly.
very good. Kazumi, you know, very good basic character. And let's just see.
She is. I think she suits Lazy Lady's playstyle very well, but he's taking a bit of damage now from the pokey pokes from Kolonov. Final round. Bit of a BM up or three.
It just
there.
Seems like whoever's like getting the offense off, you know, making the other person guess react, you know. And if you don't have that, like, ability to see all the lows and everything like that, it's basically your turn all the time.
Exactly.
Hitting him. Oh, unfortunately, doesn't get
almost
that
got it. As well, that thing is
that would have
dirty.
Been
there.
Yeah, it's nasty. This account hit.
Oh, my God! Gets hit. Bring him up.
You have
that's so hard, mate. Let me show you that. Oh, it doesn't break the throw as well. He's
okay, to watch this mix up.
Oh, great punish. Oh, Lazy Dave crunches it out again. He goes up one game. Holding the fourth for Sydney. Can he keep it up, though?
Did you see that? He was right.
Why is it so quiet?
I like that. He was basically next to the character, floated even closer towards him. Yeah, that is actually one move I haven't seen Lazy Dave actually use, the running two, which is very, very good.
Yeah.
Okay, that should be it. Ooh, just froze into the balcony.
Straight into a one round up for Kolonov. Reminder that this is the best out of five. winner of this goes to the grand final. Yeah. Keep capitalization.
Down here. Spikes him. Gets a bit of free damage. Now at the wall.
Laser Dave cheekily finding a way off the wall though.
Yeah, and
very
putting
good.
Collins.
Great whiff punish there as well, but nothing off it.
Oh,
that's dirty. He's the laser that time in. Very, yeah, very,
very good
play
Round off. Cost him last time.
It did, yeah, it absolutely did, and he knew it was.
He waited till they basically scoot back up before through that low.
And that's an example of someone who knows how to play in tournaments and knows how to adapt quickly in a certain situation. You need to think about things like that.
Reactions are one thing, but timing is a very big thing you also have to account for
exactly.
As well.
Exactly.
Oh, nice.
It brings out the combo.
Wall to wall.
Wall to wall, off the balcony with the tiger. Don't know what that was. Oh, great, Floyd's here.
Okay.
Laser Dave should have this round.
That should be it. And a Tiger to finish.
Tiger goes straight through the gate. Fight.
Oh, climbing back. There you go, the running two. Sion yelling that out loud, letting him know. That's like,
that was actually really nice. That was delicious. Well done, Dave. Oh, but he dropped it again!
Oh! Like it doesn't have life that much on it. There you go.
Float, this will finish. KO. Equalize again. Final round. Both times now, Kolonov had the strong lead and Laser Dave managed to come back each time. Kolonov needs
fair trade.
What he's doing.
Rolls forward though, I'm not too sure about that.
Oh, great sidestep. Was that, what, can we sidestep do that? Oh,
wow,
very low.
See that?
Bring it back. Oh, great patience there as well. And
that was really nice. I'm not sure they saw that, but it was basically like, you know, baiting jabs out. He knew that like Dave was going to do it because he
exactly.
was already on plus and he wanted to continue that.
It was. It was a smart play by Kolonov. Equalized he 1-1.
Nice. Day one, last setup.
Yeah.
Wow, David's not, he's not hit confirming the 1-1-2s. Because he could get a knockdown and then do that little flying thing she does.
Yeah. Did a bit of damage
there,
pushed him up there.
Unfortunately the wall was there, couldn't do any more damage.
Yeah.
Punches her in the gut.
Oh, great work by Kolonov. Oh, but not much off it.
Oh,
and that's how he's going to finish that one up, and now call up one round up.
Yeah, such a good move. As soon as you know they're going to throw a height, low crush count hit.
Oh, 100%. Oh, another forge. I think that was actually a mistake by Kolonov. Yeah. Looks like he jumped back there. But Dave's not given any mercy there. He's
yeah, exactly.
All the way.
Take it. Why not?
I mean, it's a tournament. You know Kolonov would as well. Yeah. I would.
There you go.
No, he delayed it a bit too long there.
Oh, the hurt box. Oh, nice.
Dave just being patient.
Just being patient, doesn't want to get up in the wrong way. This game actually not... Yeah.
Oh, wait! Oh, but he couldn't launch him! If he launched him, he would have won that there. But he plays in rage. And Laser Dave takes it, it's now 1-1. Just a reminder, Laser Dave is holding down the fort for New South Wales, Sydney in particular. Kolonov trying to show the boys what Brisbane's got.
Oh, a bit too far. Unfortunately, wild rising moves, except for this 4-4, unfortunately you can't capitalize on a lot of like the max range down back 4 wheelers.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, shipping that health away.
Oh, I don't know why he didn't finish it up there. That was a beautiful whiff punch.
Yeah. Caught flinching.
Orbital sun.
Yeah.
Finishes it off in style as well. We say it's in style, but it is kind of a safe way.
Yeah.
Is that subtitled? Has it always been subtitled?
Round 4.
Anyway, yeah, look, it is a safe way to finish it off. You don't want to drop your end R. Oh, I don't know, McNaz, I care about the story. Nah, I'm just kidding, no, I really don't. Kolonov looking very strong here, bringing Dave back to the wall.
Doesn't get the wall spot.
Oh, having you back to the wall with the lines in front of you is also a scary, scary place to be.
Anything minus 12 because you're going to get wall splat.
Oh, he stuck the high launch, but fortunately no good for Laser Dave. Kolonov now up yet another game. 2-1. Kolonov is one game away from making it to the grand final. I'm going to say my goodbyes to the Beast, who's heading back down to Melbourne.
Round 1.
Thank you for coming out, my man. See you soon, man. See you, Bam.
Perfect. Just letting people know so they don't have to ask where we're from.
Hold on, where's the lead again? Let's see what Dave can Lazy Dave can change up. It's actually quite intense right now. Both players just eyes are locked on the screen. Mm. Oh, foot on the wall.
Oh, place nice break. What you gonna do?
Oh! Unfortunately, nothing there from David. Lazy Dave, I'm gonna help him finish it there.
Slow donkey kick.
The corner managing to clutch it out again, something he's just fantastic at.
The power of new moves. Had some more behind me looking very sus. Can you please go back over there, please?
Yeah, sorry, mate. Commentator's only.
Should be taking this one. Just chip him out. No need to do any, like, you know, risky moves.
Don't write it off yet, though. Don't write it off just yet. We've seen a few good clutch moves from Lazy Dave as well. Call up playing very patient and very nice there. Just kept it
just waiting for his turn. Hold up. Guaranteed. Ooh, a bit slow maybe.
Was it too slow or is it not guaranteed anymore?
I think it should be more like, they do that as an option rather than the punch to the floor, right?
Right.
Because I mean, it does more damage.
Yeah.
Or at least for mix-up. I don't know why they would use it over the punch to the floor. Oh, I'm going to hit him and just let it rip.
Oh, get floated again.
Okay, this could be it. Oh, that mix-up is actually...
Oh, gets him with the cheeky low there as well. Lazy Dave. Showing is not out of it just yet. Fight. Oh, great. Finally, Lazy Dave blocks one of those and does launch him up. That's been doing nasty damage to him. Call it back on the wall.
Oh, wow. Tiger from point blank.
Great magic forward. The wall's going to destroy that combo a little bit. Over the top, this is going to be big damage as well. He's got rage. He's got into the wall.
I've seen this.
Try to jump over, but it's not going to fall for that twice. Oh! Lazy Dave crushes it out with just a few pixels of health left. Fight. He's Lazy Dave going home.
Oh, nice stuff. Finally, hits confirms it.
Oh! Right over the top again. Lazy Dave really wants to equalize this.
Oh, he just...
Oh, and he commits to it as well. Takes an equalizer. It's now 2-2. He's caught another little shaken. We don't know, but Lazy Dave getting his momentum back. Is he going to go through the grand final? Or is yet another breezy boy going to show us what they've got from up on this? Sunshine Coast?
Sunshine? I don't know. Brisbane City?
Brisbane City, all the way from Brisbane, Vegas, baby.
Wow. Yeah. Lars has still got his wall-to-wall combos. Breaks it. Keeps him in the corner where he wants to be. Wow, that move has been...
Oh! No good there. Try to anticipate. Oh, he's got great low parry though. No running mix up there. Playing it safe. Gets him with the... just a downfall. Great patience there from Kolarov to close that out. Fight.
Oh wow.
Both players playing very patient now.
Oh wow, nice stun. He should take him all the way to the wall. Oh, just slightly short.
Oh, this is getting no good combo. No, just showing his great patience there as well.
Nice.
Gets killed by the downboard one.
Round three. Fight.
Like one round away from grand final. Gets a low shift there as well, counter here.
Oh, off axis a bit, okay. Okay, let's see what you have. So have you got these combos? Wow, okay.
Stomps on him. Oh, we get a 4-4-2.
Another one.
Oh, push the button, he's got hit by the orbital. And that's going to be it. Kolarov going through to the grand final. Valiant effort from both players. but not enough for Laser Dave to progress.
I wonder, I wonder what Colin's going to do differently this time now, right? He's got more games to work with, he's warmed up.
Well, that's the thing as well, like, Dion did down on him after only a match last time. He's got to bring something new to the table. Otherwise, you know, Dion might shoot through this. The thing is, Colin's also in the loser bracket.
Yeah, and not only that, but, like, he was getting hit by a lot of lows. He was getting hit by, like, debuggers. He was hitting, like, the hand sweep. And, you know, they're slow lows, but they're very awkwardly timed, you know?
Exactly.
Like, I must have had, like, a lot of trouble with them because I react low, but then I assume the move's over and I stand back up and that's when I get hit by them.
Exactly.
So, just to see, because, you know, Jack's been in the game for a very long time, and even though, like, Colin hasn't, you know, been actively playing the game, this character's been there. So he does have, like, basic knowledge against him, you know? It's not a new character.
Yeah.
So
exactly. Dion in winner's bracket, so he only needs to win 3 games to take this out. Colin in the loser's bracket, so he will need to reset first. So he essentially needs to win 6 games to take out YSB.
Yeah. Round 1. Well, let's get a start of grand final, boys.
Here we go, grand finals. Interesting. Dion's actually used Fang. He hasn't got it with Jack.
Maybe he knows. He knows
that.
He knows something. Maybe he knows something. Well, you know what? Maybe he's just trolling. You know what? Let's see if he can beat my secondary.
Maybe. But I want to put it that far as well. I actually think it could be that. I'm trying to think of all scenarios. It could be that Dion knows how well Kolonov performs in these tournament situations. He just saw what happened to Lazy Dave. He knew that if he picks Jack again, even though it did seem like Dion had a good download on him last time, it might not have been the case this time. So mix it up, let's get someone fresh on screen.
You know, like, when someone does this to me, like in Arcus or something, they use this, like, it energizes me. Because I just want to kick their ass and get, use your main, you know?
Exactly.
Just to see what you have. So, if that were me, I would, like, I would do everything I could to
win. 100%.
Yeah.
Dion just poking Colin out. Yeah. A lot of pressure in the face and punishes the Zhu.
Wow, Dion's getting no slouch. He's doing work right now.
Yeah, absolutely. 2 rounds up already. Great start, but all great sidestep.
But also, you know, they do have a lot of big plays as well in Brisbane, you know, so he should have some experience against
him.
He
definitely does, or definitely
on the same level though as Dion.
That's where the difference is.
Yeah. And it's also a different style as well.
We've always had the better things in Sydney with people like Hentamoy, 1-2-3, 4. Obviously, Dion playing him as well. Team is not bad.
And not only that, but it's also like, you know, a game of styles as well. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
It is. His move list is huge. It's similar to Xiaoyu.
Doesn't do the launch, but that's okay. Still getting good damage. Look at him just exchanging pokes.
Yeah, that was a good little block there by Kolonov.
And Kolonov actually getting, like, the better exchange of him right now. He's punishing more lows. But then, just as I say that, Dion coming back. Oh, almost getting the
lead. He's using a lot of moves. He's using a lot of different moves. Oh, not an ideal punish there, but he got something. And he gets tripped, gets a counter hit, and Kolonov has equalized the rounds. Fight. No duck there for follow-up.
Oh wow, gets a float, gets a combo.
Loads him, finishes him off. Not a massive amount of damage, but that's going to make it big damage.
Wow, Dion just smothering him, just getting point blank, just lows, downward one, lows.
Yeah.
And then, as always, he's got the sway back.
Just keeps it clean, keeps it systematic, and that's put him one game up now, so he's 2 games away from victory. Round 1. Fight. Very, very strong start from Dion. Oh, didn't get the shoulder follow up there, unfortunately, but still quite the health lead, so not the biggest issue for him.
Oh,
gets the shoulder anyway. I think he anticipated a sidestep there, maybe. And
seeing a bit of like a resemblance of a handsome boy.
He's learned well.
Oh, interrupts him for his dynamic entry. Oh, wow.
Hold on, stay on the ground. Bit too scared to get up.
Yeah.
Oh, finally
nice,
gets a little
nice. Arctic blast. And you know, this game like being like more forgiving in like the get-ups in this game, but still they're being very, very careful with the way they're choosing how to, you know, get back up.
Yeah.
Oh no,
great sidestep as well. Colin making great use of the sidestepping at the moment.
Yeah. He's noticing that Dionys is throwing a lot of back balls, you know, so he's taking advantage. Oh, they're scared now. They're scared of the sidestep.
Exactly. Oh, no punisher as well. Now for a 3 bite from Dion. Great, done it again.
A very good tool.
Corner's starting to build some momentum now as well. Look at that damage. Oh, no punish on the wall, standing 3. Goes for a bit of a Hail Mary. Actually, he's hitting this time. Of course, Dion gave up his rage, and now what you got, he's going to get jabbed out of it. Colin, 2 rounds up as well, looking to equalize the game.
Wow, I really like this. Colin's really... Wow. He's really adjusting.
He's really adjusting really quickly. Really very well. I wonder if that means Dion's going to switch back to Jack, though, after... If he does drop the game. That was great.
Yeah, so... I actually played Colin in... my schools, and you know, I beat him the first game, but he just said, you know, that was my mistake, and then we rematched, and I never beat him another round again.
You beat me. Sorry, that was my mistake.
Yeah.
Call off. Equalizes it.
Oh, are we? Was that an instant rematch? Or
I looked away because I was updating the score, but it certainly wasn't an instant rematch. Dion not switching back to Jack just yet, I want to say. Well, let's see how we go. But I mean, this is what I was saying, where I said maybe Dion knew something or saw something in Colin that he knew Jack wasn't going to be good enough. This time, and another great sidestep. It's 5 plus 2, right? That
Yeah, 4 to 1 plus 2.
4 to 1 plus 2.
Round 2. Fight.
Oh, wow.
Great whip punch as well.
He's spacing. He's just on point. He's just like, dude, I'm in Zen mode right now. He's just fucking seeing every goddamn
blow. So impressed. And like, oh.
His decision making right now.
Even
make that work. Yeah. Even make that work. I don't even know what happened, but it was good. Stop. Oh. Oh wow, this
big shoulders. Oh, that was actually the rage drive version. So no rage and two rounds as well.
What are you thinking right now, if you were Dion?
How the hell is this guy who is only just come back to the scene kicking my ass? That's what I'd be thinking.
Oh. Wow, this combo's feel like never end.
When does it end?
Oh, just let him know. I will do it. I've hit you with this 5 times and I'll even do it to the air.
Vegas just scared. Oh, doesn't block the down back to 4, I think. Good get up. And that's actually going to be blocked. I thought I might have hit there for a second, but no bueno.
Round 4. Fight.
It's so awesome too, because we got to play Colin a couple of weeks ago, or about a month, three weeks ago, when he came down for YSB last time.
Yeah.
And even between those two YSBs, I noticed a huge improvement in his game, and it's great. Gets him out of the top as well!
His approach is just amazing right now. Is it going to be a rematch? I mean, I guess the thing is, like, you know, he's the answer in winner's brackets, you know? He's got a couple of things to...
But still, you don't want to toy around too much in a tournament, and Colin's... You know, gonna reset it in the game. So,
and not only that, but like you're using like a secondary character. Whatever you learn or condition with this match might not translate to if you switch over to Jack.
Exactly,
right?
exactly. So it defeats the purpose of the Longstead. And
yeah, exactly.
It's almost like the advantage then would go to Colin, who would build up momentum by then.
Yeah. But I'm just happy to see more Tekken.
Yeah, 100%.
And these guys are pretty high level, even though like it's Dion secondary. He's still doing pretty.
Yeah, well,
not bad.
Colin hasn't reset it just yet. Dion's still looking strong.
Round 2. Fight.
Oh wow.
It's like DL playing.
See, this is the good fundamentals.
Look at this patience.
This fundamentals.
Look at this patience.
Plus 2 is like minus 1 or 2 sidesteps. He knows that if he retaliates with a jab, he could just go in and I think blast him.
Exactly.
Dion knows that, so he's scared to best buttons as well. But then that just means Colin can do whatever he wants.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
You want some more shoulders, mate? Whoa! Great lead there by Dion as well. Looking to equalize the matches. It is a great chance for Dion to place the thing, but I mean, we've had casuals all day, so.
But we all know Dion. He likes to have fun. He likes to mess with people.
That is true,
know?
As well, yeah.
True, yeah.
Maybe this is for the cameras.
this is probably for the
oh, well, he's really put on the corner there. Dion's still looking strong. He's not going to take it out by winning the next game. That's all he needs.
Yeah.
Colin, on the other hand, looking to reset the bracket and run it back.
Round one. Fight.
Wow, just a hop kick, just to let you know if you run in, you're going to get kicked in the face. Cartwheel. Bro, no break. See, this is what I mean about like setting up throws. You know, you go for a whiff,
yep.
They're expecting something else, you just throw.
Exactly. Like,
they're probably committing to sidestepping or doing something.
Yeah, exactly.
Texas though, at least. Oh, wow.
Excuse me.
Round two.
That was good.
Fight.
That was very nice. That's all I got to say about it.
Wow, this is taking a swing for the other side now.
Wow. Back one at the shoulder. Yeah, this is really swung around now.
Yeah.
Did Colin run out of steam? What's going on?
Or did Dion take that time to, you know, see his like offense pattern, you know?
Well, I think maybe he did. Out. Maybe he did, which is why he's being a bit more patient. Just let him come in and you just eat some stuff and oh, no shoulder.
Yeah, that was a right punish, but it was a bit too slow.
Way too slow.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know who won there for
good
a minute.
Good trade.
Fight.
Stumps on his head.
Doesn't fall for the setup. Nice. Oh, see? Just throws it out.
It does it again. Yeah. I wouldn't be surprised if we see another one. Oh, he doesn't need it. He's going to get one of those. Oh. And he's now one round away from resetting the bracket.
Round four. Fight.
Oh, great. How you guys are the final round as well. I'm clinching my fist with every round. This is such close round.
Really, really close. He's calling in to reset the bracket. He's got a really good chance. He's got more than a life, yeah. Oh! Let's just let him finish it first. And there it is, Colin up, that's a bracket. We have another best out of five set, people. Straight to character select. Are we gonna see some
trials? Even goes for the character select, cancels it, and then goes back to...
Oh, I didn't even see that, not that in the score. So Dion gonna stick with
Oh no.
No, I'm going to character select.
Dion's so nervous he selected the wrong.
Maybe.
His hands are jittering right
or
now.
Or is he wasting time to reset his mind, you know, take a bit of a breather, let the momentum settle.
This is Dion. He pressed the wrong thing. This is Dion we're talking about. He clearly pressed the wrong thing.
He definitely pressed the wrong button.
He's got a lot of high pressure. He's got like fans in the crowd. He doesn't even know what's happening.
You know, he's literally got fans in the crowd.
Yeah.
Let's get some play cam going for a sec while we're loading there. There we go. Is Zahn still it? Yeah, he is.
Oh.
Alright, here we go, boys.
Fight.
Both players now in what is effectively losers. So this is a best out of five set, first of three. Whoever wins three games takes YSB. The last two YSBs have been a bracket reset as well. So I wonder if Colin can do the same here today.
See, I'm not too sure if like what Dion just did there, where you know usually second is out of that was a smart strategy because now obviously Colin's like on a high, you know, he just reset the brand.
Yeah,
and he's warmed up, and yeah, just after that, yeah, I can tell Dion's like a little bit on tilt.
Maybe.
But then again, he's been under high pressure situation in this game.
Exactly, and like
time and time again,
Colin still clearly has the momentum right now.
Fight.
And did he and
oh, that's gonna be launched.
Yeah. He did the right punish. But that was 14 for 14.
Yeah.
Stabbing. Getting his plus frames. Going for the low.
Oh.
Round three.
You're falling, I need to charge.
Fight.
Oh, is he yours? Can I borrow it?
Alright, cool. Phone on charge, boys. Alright, so we're one round, one round.
That's right. You know, Leon, like, he used Jack as his main in, like, 7. He did very well in Evo. Not only that, but he also got into red ranks in Japan, right?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. So definitely he's got his fundamentals, yeah.
Yeah, he spends a lot of time, but Jack doesn't kill him with that. He shouldn't have quit with his food there. That was playing with his food. Oh, whilst getting 4 to close it out there.
Yeah, not only did he get red, but he wanted to make sure it was consistent inside of the second card.
Exactly.
To see if he can get it to red.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, his goal was be consistent at getting to red, not just to get there.
Okay, punish. Ooh, misses it.
And Dion's going to take the first game there. Dion up one game. He's 2 games away from victory. Looking a lot more comfortable on Jack than he did with Feng. I mean, he gave Feng a crack.
Only an effort, yeah.
Yeah,
he did well.
I made a comment earlier.
But now it's serious business.
It is. And I made a comment earlier where I said, you know, he's been playing casual all day, but playing your character in a tournament is a completely different thing. So, yeah, it was a good chance for him to get some tournament experience. And that's going to be a launch as well.
Yeah.
Nice little combo.
He's been missing them, man. And not only that, like, it's optimal punish, but at the same time, it gives Dion a chance to launch him back.
Exactly.
Is it really worth it, you know? 4-2-4, like, pretty good. Knockdown.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Great wall standing. 1 there by Dion.
Oh, misses the combo.
Oh, gets punished as well. Nice clean round by Dion. 2 rounds up here. Looking to take out the second game. He's looking at victory now. He wants to win. He lost the last wise beat of Krokop in the bracket reset. Dion's not letting that happen again.
Yeah. This is his game to lose, basically, right? I mean, he's got to switch it up. Does he have enough time? He's got... Okay. Good trade. To the wall again. Mix up. High low. Switch. Yes. He's just waiting for him to play something punish one. He's just gonna,
that's what he's gonna do.
Yeah.
He's just gonna wait for the right moment there.
Yeah.
And that was a very good display of patience. A lot of people are going to get scared and think that the low's coming, they're gonna twitch or something and they're gonna get launched.
Yeah, just take the safe option. You got a lot of health to play with, right?
Exactly. And you need to think about
it. And if last throws anything that's like very slow to give him big damage, just block him, punish, and that'll definitely kill him with a sliver of like life that he had anyway.
And, like, the thing is, as well, you need to think about how your opponent is thinking. Like, it's a classic mind game, but an opponent who, like, if you've got such a big life lead, and your opponent has such a small amount of health remaining in that same situation...
Yeah, they need to take the big risk. Yeah.
They're going to do a Hail Mary, but at the same time, when you go a level further, then the opponent might think, oh, he's going to go for the big low, he's going to go for the Hail Mary and duck, and that's when the mid-launch is going to hit. So, that's Tekken.
Yeah. The layers and layers of mix-ups.
Exactly. Yeah, great duck launch there by Kolonov.
For the wall. I see Dion, like, ducking a lot. Maybe he's kind of figured out, like, a pattern, you know?
Possibly. Strong fight, Kolonov though, nice. In this game.
Yeah, once he gets going, he gets going.
Absolutely.
But clearly, Dion, when he's been clutching it out of it as well. But, I don't know.
Kolonov playing very patient right now. Oh, but... Not good enough in that situation. I think he went for a sidestep there. Got popped up by the wall setting 1 by Jack. Oh, gets him in the air. Splashes him on the ground, but no follow up, unfortunately. But he doesn't need it because down forward 1's going to seal the deal for him.
Oh wow, that down forward 2 has been doing so much work. Finally gets counter hit.
Yeah, that was a nice little counter. He's gonna have his back on the wall. It's gonna be big damages from Lars. Look at that red light. Oh, great punish as well by Kornhold. Slides in, takes him out. We're going to go game up.
He's been punished for that slide a bit, a couple of times, but he's still not scared to use it. You know,
well,
like
that's
that.
Something you need to do in a tournament. You can't be scared if you've been punished a couple of times, otherwise your move list gets reduced to nothing.
Yeah, doing that game at the start of the round and at the end of the round, they're almost like two different moves.
It is, 100% it is, because your opponent's in a different place of mind each time. And look at that, Kornhold's coming back strong again as he found... Have the batteries been recharged? Oh, quick break! Oh, he does! The Kornhold goes up again.
Round 1.
I think I straight back into it. No changing off characters, which is what I expected.
Oh.
Shines the shoes. Shines the shoes again.
Kornhold's still sidestepping quite well though. It's he's bobbed down out of his little orbital. They throw perfect, gets popped up by the back turn up towards
the
one. Oh! No tricky tricks there.
Did some shenanigans there, didn't work out.
Oh, nice. Orbital Logan starts taking it back to the wall, shaking the head from Dion as well. He's not too happy about this. Let's see if he can get off the wall though.
Oh, nice.
Oh, look, hold on.
One more hit.
The rage drive takes the round there for Dion, and Dion is one round away from taking out this grand final here at YSB number 51.
Oh, this is pressuring him with the jabs, baiting him to duck, and as soon as he does, he's going to down for two.
100%. Oh, over the top again.
Wow, great anticipation of the down back one.
Oh, that damage.
Dion finding back out from the wall. Wow, that damage just piled up.
Oh, it's gone underneath!
Oh.
And that's it, a Kornhold takes out. I thought it was going to be victory for Dion, but not yet, son.
Fight.
Super intense. I love how all their grand finals have been super intense here at YSB. Kornhold not going down without a fight, but Dion putting a lot of pressure on here in the last game.
Wow, he's been really getting clipped a lot in the air.
Jack in front of you, back to the wall. Dion takes it. Smashes him straight into it, and big congratulations to Dion, but what a valiant effort from Kornhold. That was some good Tekken.
That was great. I really like that. I like the... Obviously, Dion, one of the favorites to win, as always, but very good showing by, Lazy Dave, taking out, like, two of the, like, top players here.
100%. Lazy Dave did incredible today. He should not be upset about... I mean, you're going to be upset about your loss, but he should not be too upset because he did so awesome, and I think he's got a good foundation of what to go up to improve next time.
And Kornhold as well, coming all the way here. I love people who come here and then they do well as well, you know?
100%. I was just about to say, and Kornhold as well, this is the second time I've seen him at YSB. He doesn't have much experience with FR. Well, this isn't FR, this is Kornhold Tekken 7, but, like, much experience with anything after Vanilla Tekken 7. The improvement I've seen of Kornhold between the two times he's been here has been great. Imagine what he's going to be next time.
Yeah, exactly. Imagine he had the game at home. Imagine we all had the game at home.
I'm
going to change very soon.
I'm scared.
Yeah.
But we will see in the near future. We better sign up because we're getting
I'm hungry. I'm so hungry right now.
Yeah. I'm starving as well. I want to go punch a dozer. So, everyone, thanks for tuning in.
Thanks, guys.